Good morning, everyone. Parang tulog pa. Good morning po. Amen and amen. And if you're blessed today, could we just give God our very best clap offering? Amen and amen. And you know what? I have good news for you. Why, for the last past Sundays, for the past months, we've been praying for an increase sa ating attendance po, di ba? Tama po ba yun? So ang ating attendance last month, nag-150, nag-160, 161, 170. But guess what? Last Sunday po, ang ating attendance was 178 po ang ating attendance. We just give God our very best clap offering, and it's just the start of the year. And you know what? God will be doing greater and amazing things for our lives. Amen? And amen. And I have another good news. Next week po, hindi po ako magpipreach. Kasi po, yung aking daddy po ang magpipreach ngayon, next Sunday. So, sa mga nakilala, si Pastor Anthony Velasco, siya po yung ating national overseer for the whole Philippines, and he will be visiting. Sabi niya, naaawa na siya sa akin dahil ako every Sunday. So, tutulungan niya ako next Sunday, siya ang magpipreach dito sa atin. Amen po ba doon? Excited po ba kayo? So, please invite your friends, invite your family members, and we're gonna have a great time with the Lord next week. Amen po? And today, we're gonna proceed with God's Word. But before that, I would like to ask you this question. Sa inyo po ba, sa inyo pong lifetime, have you experienced to be a judge? Sino po naka-experience na maging judge dito? Siguro sa isang contest, sa isang showtime, sa church, siguro pinili kayong judge. Pero sa experience po ba na yun, was it easy? Siguro some of us, it wasn't easy. Why? Because sa ibang contest, tulad po sa Miss Universe, di ba, you will be the one to choose who will be the winner. Tama po yun? Tama po ba yun? So, kilala niyo po ba yan? So, okay po ba yung ating pambato sa Miss Universe? So, kayo na po bahala. So, yan po. So, ang isang judge po, kaya niya, may capacity siya kung sino yung ipapanalo sa contest. But in the legal terms, kaya rin ng judge kung sino ang ipropronounce niyang guilty or not guilty. So, yan ang trabaho ng isang judge. Pero in our own ways, we could also be a judge. Just like judging on what clothing will we wear today or for tomorrow. Tulad po ni, ito po ng creator ng Facebook. Alam niyo po si Mark Zuckerberg, ang dami po kasing decisions in life. So marami na po siyang iniisip sa kanyang business. Kaya po, ayaw niya na po i-judge kung anong gusto niyang damit every day. Kaya he chose po na isang damit na lang ang kanyang susuotin every time, every day. Kasi po, there are so many decisions to make. There are so many things that you need to judge for your life. And gusto natin simplihan. And you know what? In our lives, it's not easy to judge for others. It's not easy to judge for ourselves. Why? Because in most special terms, sa mas critical positions, it will determine our future. Tama po ba yun? Amen. So there's a king here in the Bible. If you have your Bibles with you in 2 Chronicles chapter 17, verse 3 to 4. And it says here, now the Lord was with Jehoshaphat. So isa po tong hari, si King Jehoshaphat. And because sinamahan po siya ng Panginoon, because he walked in the former ways of his father David, and he did not seek the Baals, but sought the God of his father, and walked in his commandments, and not according to the acts of Israel. So right now, Jehoshaphat, King Jehoshaphat, could have two decisions. He could make the wrong judgment, or he could make the right judgment. Why? Kasi pwede siyang mag-choose. It's either he is gonna follow the rebellious kings. Alam naman po natin yung mga kings of Israel. Alam po natin yung mga nangyari sa kings of Judah. Yung iba sa kanila ay maganda yung ginawa. Yung iba po sa kanila ay sobrang pangit yung ginawa. So he could follow the evil kings, the rebelliousness, and worship Baal once again. Papurihan ang Diyos na hindi buhay, ang Diyos-Diyosan, and end up in evilness. So this is the wrong judgment. But he could also choose the right judgment wherein he will follow the leading of King David. Kilala niyo po si King David, di ba? We've talked about King David, the life of a champion. And he walked in the ways of the Lord. And not only that, he worshiped the one true and living God. And he could choose the right judgment and have to live a righteous life. So kung tayo po ang nasa sitwasyon ni King Jehoshaphat, ano pong pipiliin natin dyan? Yung wrong judgment or yung right judgment? Siyempre, he would like the right judgment, and true enough, King Jehoshaphat, kaya po siya sinamahan ng Panginoon because he chose the right judgment. He chose to follow righteousness in his life. So what happened when he chose righteousness, when he got the right judgment, in verse 5 it says, therefore the Lord established the kingdom in his hand. So ang buhay po ni Jehoshaphat ay na-establish, naiayos, naipatag ang kanyang future, sinamahan po siya ng Panginoon because he chose righteousness. He chose the right judgment in his life. At kung matatanong niyo po, si King Jehoshaphat, di ba napakagandang pangalan? Sino po ba dito ang may pangalan na Jehoshaphat? So wala pong may pangalan ng Jehoshaphat, pero pwede niyo pong ipangalan niya sa anak niyo. Why? Because the meaning of Jehoshaphat is Yahweh has judged. So kapag tayo pala ay nag-judge ng tama para sa ating buhay, we chose the right judgment, ang Panginoon na ang mag-judge sa ating buhay at gusto niya po ang kanyang judgment ay i-bless ang bawat isa na nandito ngayon. Amen po ba yun? Amen. Sige po, palakpangan po natin ang ating Panginoon. And dahil tama po ang ginawa ni Jehoshaphat, God, nag-judge siya po ng Panginoon and he was established in the days of his life. And before we proceed with God's word, let us all bow our heads and let us pray. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus Christ, Lord God, kurarasakandararasi, Lord God, we just invite your presence to be in this place. Lord God, we don't want to do this by might nor by power, but only by your spirit. Lord God, these are not my words, Lord God, for my mere words, Lord God, has no power in it. But Lord Jesus Christ, your words, Lord God, has power. It could change our lives, Lord God. It could change our future. And Lord God, we just invite you, Lord God, to open our hearts, open our minds, and Lord, just let us be blessed in your presence. We ask for your anointing. We ask for your wisdom. We ask for your favor, and we claim the victory, and we give you back all the glory and all the praise in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everybody shout, amen and amen. Can we just give God our very best clap offering? And you know what? I just remember the time in my prayer and fasting, mga 2 weeks ago, Saturday po na yun, and I was crying unto the Lord, siguro for 1 hour, I was crying to the Lord, I was just praying, and out of nowhere, I was telling God, you be the one, you be the one, you be the one. Yun po yung laman ng aking prayer. Sabi ko, Lord, ayoko na gawin to in my own strength, ayoko na gawin ang buhay ko sa sarili kong lakas. And Lord God, you be the one to change the people. You be the one to save this city. Lord God, you be the one to establish this church. Lord God, you be the one, Lord God, ikaw na bahala, Lord God, in my future. And I was praying that talagang nararamdaman ko yung presence ni Lord. And I was just letting God be the one, you be the one to establish my life. And that's what I've been crying out for in the first week para po sa atin, para po sa city natin, and for our lives. Why? Because it's so hard to judge for ourselves. Tama po ba yun? It's so hard to judge ano ba yung tamang step for tomorrow? Ano po ba yung tamang step for later? What is the next step? How could I judge the next step para maging maayos yung future ko? Para maging established yung future ko. So sabi ko kay God, ikaw na Lord bahala. You be the one to establish my life. And that's what happened when the Lord judged Jehoshaphat's life. In the next verse, it says, what happens but when the Lord judges us? It says here, and all Judah gave presents to Jehoshaphat. And he had riches and honor in abundance. And his heart took delight in the ways of the Lord. Moreover, he removed the high places and wooden images from Judah. And the fear of the Lord fell on all the kingdoms of the lands that were around Judah so that they did not make war against Jehoshaphat. So Jehoshaphat became increasingly powerful and he built fortresses and storage cities in Judah. So what happens when we give God, when we allow God to judge our lives, ganito po yun, we tell God, you be the one, ito po nangyari kay Jehoshaphat, you be the one to bring riches and honor in abundance in my life. Gusto po ba natin yun? Amen. Gusto po natin yun. Basta makarinig tayo ng riches, gusto natin yun, di ba? So some of us here are asking for financial breakthroughs. Some of us here are really asking for a breakthrough sa ating sa sarili, for our families. And pag si Lord pala ang gumalaw, you be the one, si Lord ang magbibigay ng riches and honor in abundance in our lives. Amen po ba yun? And not only that, sige po, palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. And not only that, you be the one, Lord, to delight my heart in the ways of the Lord. Why? Because it's not easy to walk in God's path. It's not easy to be a Christian. It's not easy to be here. And there's a lot of people around the world to tempt us to go back into evilness. But sinasabi natin, Lord, you be the one to allow me, Lord God, to delight in your word, to delight, Lord God, in this Christianity, to delight in your presence. Kasi hindi madali yun. And not only that, sinasabi natin kay Lord, you be the one to give peace on all sides. So pakitanong nga yung katabi mo, may kaaway ka ba ngayon? So, parang natahimik po tayo, baka may kaaway po tayo sa office, sa business, or sa relationship. But you know what? When God judges for your life, as He establishes you, no more wars in your life. There will be peace for your life today. Amen po ba yun? Amen. Sige po, palakpangan po natin si Lord dyan. And not only that, lastly, when He establishes, when He judges for you, He will pour out empowerment increasingly for your life. Kailangan natin ng kapangyarihan ng Panginoon. It's not an easy task. It's not an easy battle. We need God's power. We need God's anointing. We need God's favor and wisdom. And when God establishes us, Siya mismo ang mabibigay nun para sa atin. Amen? Amen. Why? Because God is a righteous judge. Amen po ba dun? Sa naniniwala po dun, sumigaw ng amen. Amen. God is a righteous judge. He is just. He is fair. He is equal. Yan po ang ating Panginoon, talagang pag ginawa mo ang tama, talagang ibibless ka niya. And this is His covenant for us. We could see it back in Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 26 to 28. And it says here, "Behold, I set before you today a blessing and a curse. The blessing, if you obey the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command you today. And the curse, if you do not obey the commandments of the Lord your God." Simple lang po, di ba? So kapag tayo po ay gumawa ng tama, kapag tayo ay sumunod sa Panginoon, God will give you all the blessings for your life. Amen? But if we fall short, kapag tayo po ay hindi po sumunod sa Kanya, kahit pa ulit-ulit niya tayong sinasabihin na sumunod, then a curse will be upon us. Hindi po natin kakalugdan yun. Amen po ba dun? So there is a blessing and there is a curse. Yan po ang covenant niya. Yan ang promise niya for each and every one of us. Kaya po sabi ng isang prophet in the time of Jehoshaphat, in verse 7 it says, "Now therefore, let the fear of the Lord be upon you. Take care and do it, for there is no iniquity with the Lord our God, no partiality, no taking of bribes." Why? Because our God is a righteous judge. At yun po, kapag pagkarapat dapat ka i-bless, i-bless ka ng Panginoon. Kapag karapat dapat ka i-curse, tayo rin po ay i-curse ng Panginoon. Amen po ba yun? Amen po. Kaya buti na lang po, sa buhay po ni King Jehoshaphat, God was a righteous judge. So what happened to King Jehoshaphat? He chose righteousness in his life. And you know what? When he chose righteousness, God righteously judged him. Ginudge po siya ng Panginoon. And what happened? Blessings po ang natanggap ni King Jehoshaphat. Gusto po ba natin yan? Amen. But you know what? On the other hand, may kakontemporary po si King Jehoshaphat. Naalala niyo po ba si King Ahab? So si King Ahab was the king na pinag-uusapan natin in the time of Elijah. And we know that King Ahab chose evilness in his life. Yan po ang pinili niyang track sa kanyang buhay. And God righteously judged too. Diba? Kung tama ang ginawa mo, God will righteously judge. Kapag mali ang ginawa natin, God will also righteously judge. And King Ahab is experiencing a curse in his life. Hindi po maganda ang takbo ng kanyang buhay. So kung tayo po ang nasa sitwasyon na yan, sino po ang gusto natin? Si King Jehoshaphat or si King Ahab? Kala ko may magki-King Ahab eh. Siyempre gusto natin, di ba, si King Jehoshaphat ang pipiliin natin. And we could just imagine all the people of the land, all the kings of the land, even the king of Israel, King Ahab, would love to be like King Jehoshaphat. Why? Because he has everything, he has all he needs, no wars in his life, he has abundance. At kung ako po si King Ahab, I would want him to be part of my team. And you know what? Kapag tayo po ay si King Jehoshaphat, you know what? The enemy will always try to steal, kill, and destroy our lives. Tama po ba yun? And how will he do that? He will persuade us. So ano po ba yung persuade? Anong ibig sabihin ng persuade? It means to prevail on a person to do something. So, si King Ahab po ang ginamit ng kaaway to persuade Jehoshaphat, "Uy, huwag ka na sumunod kay Lord. King Jehoshaphat, magsama na tayo. Let's do things on our own. Let's not follow God." At tayo ay gumawa ng ating sariling landas. So this is what happened in the next verse in chapter 18, verse 1, it says, "Then Jehoshaphat had riches and honor in abundance, and by marriage, he allied himself with Ahab." So ako mismo, while I was trying to understand God's word, I had this question in my mind, why did Jehoshaphat, who has everything in his life, who has abundance in his life, whom he has already God in his life, bakit pa siya nakipagkampi sa isang enemy? Bakit pa siya kumampi sa King of Israel? So yun po ang aking malaking question at that time, kasi po ganito po ang kanilang itsura. Yan po si King Ahab, he is the King of Israel, and Jehoshaphat is the King of Judah, just a small portion of the land. So syempre, hindi po gusto ni Lord yun na ba't ka pa kumampi sa kaaway, kasama mo naman ako. Tama po ba yun? Diba? Kung kasama na natin si Lord, ba't pa tayo kakampi sa iba? Malakas na ang ating kakampi. Kaya po makikita po natin dito, even people who are having abundance, who are having everything, sometimes still make the wrong judgments in life. Minsan dumadating tayo doon kahit tayo na nasa peak na, tayo ay successful na, fulfilled na tayo sa buhay. Minsan at some point, medyo nagkakamali pa rin tayo ng choices in life. And siguro, sa isip-isip ko lang, ganito rin po ang nasa isip ni King Jehoshaphat. Why? Because when I was in college, alam niyo po, nung mga first 2 years ko po in college, yung mga classmates ko, hindi ako masyadong pinapansin eh. Kasi ako yung medyo shy type, medyo nasa loner stage lang ako, wala pa akong masyadong confidence sa ginagawa ko. So kapag may mga groupings, hindi po nila ako kinukuha. Ako pa po yung nagkakandarapan na sumali sa group nila. Kasi medyo low esteem ako in my first 2 years. But ito na po, nung medyo third year, fourth year na, I was building up my confidence. Hindi na po ako bumabagsak masyado. Sila po ay bumagsak na rin. So level-level na po kami sa aming course. So medyo nakakasabay na po ako at medyo nakakaangat na po. Kaya po at that time, yung mga seniors po, may mga upper batch po kaming kasama, yung mga matatalino ko pong nakilala ng mga first 2 years, in a miracle, gusto na po nila akong kasama sa team. Oy, si AJ, isama natin sa team. Okay yan, okay yung performance niyan. So sa akin po, wow, sarap sa feeling nun ah. Sarap na kinakailangan na ako ng ibang mga tao, dun sa mga tao na i-intimidate ako. Gusto pala nila ako ngayon in their team. So ma-imagine natin ngayon kay King Ahab and King Jehoshaphat, wow! May kuya, may big kuya, sa Israel, malaki yung kanyang sakop. Wow, gusto niya akong makasama. So medyo nakakataba siguro ng puso ni King Jehoshaphat. But this is what happened in verse 2 to 3, nung magkasama na po sila, after some years, sabi po doon, after mga 9 years, he went down, Jehoshaphat went down to visit Ahab in Samaria, and Ahab killed sheep and oxen in abundance for him and the people who were with him. So grabe yung ginawa ni King Ahab. Lahat na binigay niya para kay Jehoshaphat to do what? And persuaded him to go up with him to Ramoth Gilead. So talagang tinry niya makuha si Jehoshaphat to be part of his team kasi malakas si King Jehoshaphat. So Ahab, king of Israel, said to Jehoshaphat, king of Judah, "Will you go with me against Ramoth Gilead?" And Jehoshaphat answered him, "I am as you are, and my people as your people, we will be with you in the war." So na-persuade po si King Jehoshaphat, sumama kay King Ahab, so panalong-panalo si King Ahab, at dito po sila pupunta. Pupunta po sila sa Ramoth Gilead. So yan po, nasa nakakulay po sa taas ng ulo ni King Jehoshaphat. And you know what? When I studied Ramoth Gilead, tinignan ko po yung Hebrew term ng Ramoth. Ang ibig sabihin po pala niyan ay heights. So Ramoth Gilead is a high place. And when you're in a high place, what happens? What do you have when you're in a high place? You have establishment. Why? Because you see the whole land. When you're in a high place, your life is established, your kingdom is established. Kaya gustong-gusto ni King Ahab yan. And King Jehoshaphat was also persuaded to want that establishment in his life. So ang hinahabol ng dalawang hari na ito ay maging established. But little did they know, nakalimutan po ni King Jehoshaphat na diba si Lord na ang nag-establish sa buhay niya. Tama po ba yun? Si Lord na ang nag-establish kay Jehoshaphat. Sabi po ng Panginoon, diba? You be the one. Yan po ang pinakita dyan. You be the one, na Lord. Ikaw na ma-establish sa aking buhay. Kaya lang, this time, they were persuaded to get that establishment on their own strength, on their own might. sa sarili nilang lakas. Kaya ano po nangyari? Imbis na you be the one, I be the one. I be the one to give riches and honor for my life. I be the one to try to get the right path for my life. I be the one to get my peace for my life, for my family, for my kingdom. I be the one to get my own empowerment. So, they're getting the establishment of their lives in their own strength. And you know what? Hindi ko po maitatanggi that dumating din po ako sa ganyang situation while I was leading in this church. Minsan medyo naiinip po ako. Medyo nagiging impatient po ako. Gusto ko na pong may mangyari sa church natin. Gusto ko po, in just a few months, 500 people na kagad tayo. Di ba? Maganda po yun. So minsan, I try to be, nung mga panahon na yun, iniisip ko na mas maging aggressive, gawin na yung mga bagay nito. Sabi ko, Lord, ako na gagawa. Parang LeBron James. Di ba? Ako na yung shushoot ng shushoot. So, di ba? Talo po yung Cavaliers. So, panali yung Golden State. Thank you, Lord. So, yun po. Joke lang po yun. Pero totoo, nangyari po yun. Side trip lang. Pero, yun yung gusto kong gawin. Parang yung babakawin ko na, gagawin ko na in my own strength, I be the one to do all these things. Kaya lang po, ano pong pinapakita ng Panginoon sa atin ngayon? You know what? This is just who God really is. God is a merciful God. Amen po ba yun? Dahil po yung ginagawa po nung dalawang hari na yun, na muntik ko na rin pong gawin, ay hindi po tama sa mata ng Panginoon. Why? Because if I try to do it in my own strength, oh no, this is gonna be a disaster. And makikita po natin na ang Panginoon natin is a merciful God. Why? Because when we look at in verse 16, ito pong sabi ng Panginoon, then He said, I saw all Israel scattered on the mountains, as sheep that have no shepherd. And the Lord said, these have no master. Let each return to his house in peace. Uwi na kayo. So ano po bang makikita po natin ngayon, nakita ng Panginoon that all Israel was scattered. Sabi ng Panginoon sa mga tao, you know what? I know your future. I know your future. I know your family's future. I know the future of this church. Alam ko na mangyayari, sabi ng Panginoon, 5 years from now, this is how this church will look like. And ang sabi niya, you have no shepherd. You are not established. King Ahab, King Jehoshaphat, your future is not established. And you know what? Here's what God is telling them. And kahit hindi niyo akong ginagawang master, even right now, you're not treating me as your Lord. Kahit ganun, kahit ginudyos niyo yung sarili niyo, sabi niya, kila King Ahab, I'm still trying to persuade you. I'm giving out these words. I'm giving out these warnings. Why? So that you may have peace. Para ikaw po ay masave na of out of all these mess. So, di ba? Ang sarap ng warning ng Panginoon, di ba? Ang sarap ng mercy ng Panginoon. I know your future. It's not established. I am your God. I'm persuading you because I want to save your life. So, sarap. Ang sarap ng mercy ng Panginoon. Nililigtas niya po talaga tayo. But, tignan nyo nga naman ang sagot ni King Ahab sa Panginoon. In verse 17, it says, and the king of Israel said to Jehoshaphat, did I not tell you he would not prophesy good concerning me, but evil? Pambihira, no? Yung magandang loob na ng Panginoon, yung mercy ng Panginoon, King Ahab took it offensively. Sabi niya, Lord naman, maliit na bagay lang to. Pagbigyan mo na kami. Lord naman, lalaban na nga kami. Para sa'yo din naman to. Ba't mo kami pinipigilan? So they took it offensively. Kaya sumagot ulit ng Panginoon sa kanila. In verse 22, it says, therefore, look, the Lord has put a lying spirit in the mouth of these prophets of yours, and the Lord has declared disaster against you. Pambihira. Winarningan na, hindi nakinig. So this time, wala na pong magagawa si Lord. He's a righteous judge, and He will judge accordingly to these two kings. And true enough, ito po ang nangyari sa kanila. Tumuloy pa din po sila in verse 28, it says, so the king of Israel and Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah, went up to Ramoth Gilead. And what happened? Sumama po sila. So kung ako po si King Jehoshaphat, siguro po nagdadalawang isip na po ako kung sasama. Pero siguro, still, na-persuade pa rin siya ni King Ahab. Sabi mo, sasamahan mo ako eh. Di ba, nagsabi ka na, let your word be your word, let your yes be yes. So wala po nagawa si Jehoshaphat. Sumama pa rin po siya kay King Ahab. And true enough, disaster was upon both of these kings. Si King Ahab po ay namatay, or just a random shot of an arrow, siya po ay natira, and he was shot dead in action. And ano naman kaya ang nangyari sa isang hari, si Jehoshaphat, na mahal ng Panginoon? In verse 31, it says, "So it was, when the captains of the chariots saw Jehoshaphat, that they said, 'It is the king of Israel.' Therefore, they surrounded him to attack, but Jehoshaphat cried out, and the Lord helped him, and God diverted them from him." So ano nangyari? Akala ko ba righteous judge si... Kaya sa piano here. Akala ko ba righteous judge tong si Lord? Bakit ganun? Ba't si King of Israel namatay? Eh bakit si Jehoshaphat, how was he able to persuade the Lord? How was he able to persuade God? So ito pong sabi, so nakaligtas po si King Jehoshaphat. Siya po ay nakauwi sa kanyang tahanan, safe and sound, dahil niligtas po siya ng Panginoon. So in verse 2 to 3, it says, in the next chapter, sabi dito, "And Jehu, the son of Hanani the seer, went out to meet him." Nako, ito na. Isang propeta ng Panginoon, expect na ni Jehoshaphat na siya ay papagalitan, siya ay sesermonan, alam niyo yung feeling na yon. "And said to King Jehoshaphat, 'You know what? Should you help the wicked and love those who hate the Lord? Therefore, the wrath of the Lord is upon you.'" So, ang bigat ng salita ng Panginoon sa kanya, no? Lagot ka. Diba? Kasi, alam, pambihira ka naman, King Jehoshaphat. Sinamahan na kita all your years. God had already established your life. Tapos, ito pa yung gagawin mo. Kakampi ka pa sa kaaway. I-establish mo pa yung buhay mo on your own strength. Ba't ka naman ganun? Kaya ngayon, sabi ng Panginoon, you're gonna experience that disaster. You're gonna experience the wrath of God. So kung tayo po yan, parang, wala. Oh no, I'm living in darkness. My future is not established. Oh no, this is the end of my life. Hindi nga ako namatay, pero makarinig ako na galit ang Panginoon sa akin, tapos tayo dyan, di ba? Wala na mangyayari sa buhay ko. But in the next verse, ito po yung mercy ng Panginoon. Sabi niya, nevertheless. Nevertheless. Nevertheless what? Nevertheless, good things are found in you, in that you have removed the wooden images from the Lord and have prepared your heart to seek God. Grabe po ang mercy ng Panginoon kasi grabe yung ginawang kasalanan ni King Jehoshaphat. Somehow, unforgivable yun kasi he was rebellious to God. Pero ito ang mercy ng Panginoon. God's mercy magnifies the good in you when you turn back to Him. Amen na po ba yun? Ulitin ko po yung God. Sige po, palakpan po natin si Lord. God's mercy magnifies the good things you've done when you turn back to Him. Yes, pangit ng ginawa mo. Hindi tama. It's not pleasing to God. Pero sabi ni Lord, nevertheless, dahil bumalik ka sa akin, titignan ko yung mga maganda mong ginawa at kakalimutan ko na lahat ng mali mong nagawa. Amen po ba dun? So yan po ang na-receive na mercy ni King Jehoshaphat. That's why in the next verse, this is what he felt, this is what he did. So Jehoshaphat dwelt at Jerusalem, and he went out again among the people from Beersheba to the mountains of Ephraim and brought them back to the Lord God of their fathers. Because he realized his mistakes, he realized what he's done. So sabi niya sa tao niya, "Judah, let's go back to God. Papurihan natin ang Panginoon." And where did King Jehoshaphat lead the people? And everything that he had realized for the point of death that he had experienced, ito ang masasabi niya para sa atin. Ito ang masasabi niya para sa tao. Sabi niya, "You know what? Allow God to establish you. Allow God to judge for you. You don't need to fear. Yes, He's perfect. He's God. He's almighty. But He's a righteous judge. And when He judges you accordingly, pambihira, He's gonna establish your life, your family, and your future. And yes, we're just humans. We're imperfect and we're going through tough times. But sabi ni Lord, you know what? Just behave in the Lord. just behave in the Lord. You saw how merciful God is. So pag na-warning na tayo, makinig na tayo. At kapag may mga moments na hindi po tayo nakinig, just go back to Him and behave in the Lord. At mararamdaman natin ang mercy niya. And after that, courageously follow the Lord. Courageously. Sumunod tayo ano mang sinasabi ng Panginoon, ano niyang pinapagawa niya. Just courageously follow God. Why? Because God is love. God loves you so much. And hindi ka niya matiis kasi mahal na mahal ka niya. Pag bumalik ka sa kanya, wow, you can return to Him. Ano mang nagawa mo in the past, ano mang darkest secrets mo na hindi mo sinasabi sa tao, ano man yan, whatever that may be, you can return to Him. And when you return to Him, wow, He's gonna embrace you, He's gonna receive you because He loves you. And not only that, this is the most special part, when you return to Him, He's gonna change your life. He's gonna change your life and you will never be the same again. Amen? Amen. Sige po, palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. This is the love of God. And when we experience that, wow, pag naramdaman na natin ng pagmamahal ng Panginoon, pambira, ibabalik ka niya pa rin sa kanyang promise. And He will still be the one to bring riches and honor and abundance for your life. Still allow you to delight in His presence, in God's Word. And He's gonna remove still all those fears, all those wars, give you peace and empower you till the last day, till the last breath of your life. Yan ang pangako ng Panginoon para sa atin. Amen? Amen. Could you just give God a very best clap offering again? Hallelujah. And I would like to end here in a person we could relate to. Hindi na po ito hari. Isang normal na tao na lang to. In John chapter 8, verse 3 to 5, it says, "Then the scribes and Pharisees brought to Jesus Christ a woman caught in adultery." So isang babae po na to, who is not established. Kasi nabansaga na siyang adulteress. So kapag adulteress ka, wow, hindi ka re-respetuhin ng tao kahit sino man. At alam po yun ng lahat. Wala ka nang established, wala kang attorney na sasalo sa'yo. Bakit? Adulteress ka eh. Your stand, your case is not established. Walang makakatulong sa'yo. Not only that, and when they had set her in the midst of the people, they said to Jesus Christ, "Teacher, this woman was caught in adultery in the very act." Jesus, huling-huli. Walang takas. So, ang babae po na ito, kung lalagay po natin ang ating sarili sa babae na ito, wow. I'm really living in darkness. All the people surrounding me, they now know I'm an adulteress and they caught me in the very act and I'm in front of Jesus Christ who is perfect, who could judge for my life. At sabi po nila kay Jesus, "Now, Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned." Lord, sabi sa kasulatan, sabi sa law, ang taong to dapat mamatay. Dapat batuhin. This woman should be stoned. That's the right judgment. So kapag tao po ang magja-judge sa atin, pambihira, kamatayan na kagad ang mararamdaman natin. But what do you say? Lord Jesus Christ, di ba you are Lord? Di ba you are the King of Kings and Lord of Lords? Now, how will you judge this woman? Everything caught in the act, wala tong laban, dapat mamatay na yan. So medyo hindi po nagsalita si Jesus Christ, medyo nakabuelo na po siya. In verse 7 it says, "He who is without sin among you, let him throw a stone at her first." Yan po ang sinabi ni Jesus sa mga taong nanonood sa adulteress na yon, sa sinful woman na yon. Sige, kung sino ang walang kasalanan, go ahead, batuhin mo. And what was Jesus Christ telling the people, the crowd? You don't have the right to judge. You don't have the right to judge. Why? Because you yourself is sinful. You yourself is like that adulteress. How could you throw the first stone? So nung sinabi po yun ni Jesus, totoo nga naman, words of wisdom, sila po ay onting-onting lumayo. The crowd went away. Kasi, totoo nga naman, paano ko babato? May kasalanan din ako. They don't have the right to judge. So nang naiwan na po si Jesus at yung adulteress, yung babae, ito pong sinabi niya, when Jesus had raised himself up and saw no one but the woman, he said to her, woman, where are those accusers of yours? Nasaan na yung mga nagja-judge sa iyo na tao? Nandiyan pa ba sila? Has no one condemned you? Diba? Open your eyes. Wala na yung mga nagja-judge. Wala na yung mga kaaway mo. And she said, yes, Lord, no one is there anymore. And Jesus said to her, neither do I condemn you. Those people has no right to judge you. But I, Jesus Christ, I am the righteous judge. And I have the right to judge you. And yes, technically you are guilty. But because I will be the one, you presented yourself to me, and I will be the one to judge you, and this is my judgment, you are not guilty. Today, you are not anymore guilty. You're free from all your sins. You're free from all that you've done. Today, you're not guilty anymore. And as you receive this righteousness, as you receive this mercy, you felt it, right? As you receive this love right now, this is what I've done to you. You're not an adulteress anymore. You're a woman already. You are sacred already, free from all your sins. Could you just do this for me? Go and sin no more. Go and sin no more. Go and sin no more. Then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. I am the righteous judge. I could pronounce you guilty or not guilty. I could give you a blessing or a curse. Today, right now, I could give you life or death. Because that's who Jesus Christ is, and told them, here's the thing, he who follows me shall not walk in darkness anymore, but the light of life for your life today. Just follow me. Just courageously follow my love for you. And you're gonna receive the light in the darkness of your life today. Amen. So, ramdam na ramdam po natin ang pagmamahal ng Panginoon ngayon. At kung tao po ang magja-judge sa atin, kung hahayaan po natin na ang tao ang magja-judge sa atin ng pambihira, nabato na tayo. Dahil tayo po ay makasalanan, wala po talaga tayong takas dun. But today, alam ko po, natatakot po tayo kay Lord because He's perfect, He's almighty, He's powerful. But as we present ourselves to Him, we could tell Him right now, Lord, pwede ba ikaw yung mag-judge sa akin? Kasi pag ikaw pala nag-judge sa akin, pambihira. You could pronounce me pala not guilty. And today, that's what we're gonna do today. If you want God to be your judge, to judge your life today, and receive His righteousness, receive His mercy today, whatever you've done, and receive that love. As the worship team sings this song, I invite you to come to the altar and God will be your judge. Yahweh has judged. So if that's you, as they sing this, you can come here in front and we will pray for you.
everything I need is you, my beginning, my forever. Everything I need is you. Let me sing, oh, for love, and I will join the angel's song. Ever holy is the Lord, King of glory, King of hope. Oh, how many times have I broken your heart, but still you forgive. If only I ask, Lord, how many times have you heard me pray? Draw near to me.
Beginning.
See everything I need, everything I need is you. My beginning, my forever, Lord. Everything I need is you.
Jesus. Hallelujah, God Almighty. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. We worship you. We adore you, God. Here we are right now in your presence. Lord God, we are truly guilty, Lord God, of all the things you've done. And it's just right, Lord God, to pronounce curse for our lives. Because we've done so many wrong things in our lives. But thank you, Jesus Christ, of your righteousness. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, of your mercy. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for your love. And now we are pronounced not guilty. And we are safe. We are safe from the darkness of this world. Hallelujah. And for those who came here in front, we just raise up our hands to God. This is truly an act of surrender. When we raise up our hands, we say surrender. And right now in front of God, we're telling God, Lord, surrender. Here we are, Lord, surrendering to you. Can you just join me in this prayer? Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
I come before you today.
I come before you today.
Bringing all my sinfulness.
Bringing all my sinfulness.
I could not deny that I've done all those wrong.
That I've done all those wrong.
In my life.
In my life.
But I come before you today.
But I come before you today.
I present my life.
I present my life.
I present my case.
I present my case.
Here I am, Lord.
Here I am, Lord.
A sinful man.
Sinful.
Sinful woman.
Sinful woman.
But Lord Jesus Christ.
But Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you for you.
Thank you for you.
Thank you for your love.
Thank you for your love.
Thank you for your forgiveness.
Thank you for your forgiveness.
Thank you for your mercy.
Thank you for your mercy.
That this day.
I am still.
Alive.
Alive.
Because you have shed light.
Because you have shed light
in my life today.
In my life today.
And it's so refreshing.
And it's so refreshing.
To be pronounced.
To be pronounced.
Not guilty.
Not guilty.
Because Yahweh.
Because Yahweh
has judged for my life.
For my life.
And my life today.
And my life today.
Will never be the same again.
Never be the same.
Because
again.
You, God Almighty,
has established
my life.
My life.
My family.
My family.
And my future.
And my future.
Hallelujah. Just give God our very best clap offering. Hallelujah. That's who our God is. That's who He is in our lives. God loves you so much today. Amen. And today, before we end, we just raise up our tithes and offering to Him as an act of thanksgiving, as an act of worship for Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God Almighty. Could we all rise up from our seats and let us raise up our tithes to Him. Lord Jesus Christ, thank You for this wonderful offering, Lord God. Thank You for this wonderful tithes, Lord. Lord God, thank You, Lord God, that in spite, Lord God, of our sinfulness, wow, You've been still giving us blessings and blessings, abundance of blessings in our lives. And that's how You have mercy upon us. That's how You have loved us, Lord God. Thank You so much. That's why, Lord God, ayaw namin ito ipagdamot sa'Yo. Lord God, ayaw na namin itong dayain, Lord God. This is Yours, Lord God. Ayaw namin itong, ayaw ka naming tipirin, Panginoon. Bakit, Panginoon? Kasi Ikaw mismo, Panginoon Hesukristo, hindi mo kami tinipid. Hindi lang yun, Panginoon, kami, ang buhay namin ay niligtas mo pa sa kapahamakan, Lord God, from hell, Lord. And it's just right, Lord God, to worship You with all that we have right now. And Lord God, thank You for this wonderful service. Thank You for this wonderful day. Lord God, thank You once again for Your wonderful word, Panginoon. And Lord God, we don't want to go back to our sinfulness anymore. Lord God, today as we have received Your love, as we have received Your mercy, as we have received Your righteousness, Lord God, yes, Lord, we have felt it, we have received it, and we don't want to sin anymore. Today, your lives are changed because Jesus Christ entered your life today. And you're going to be a blessing to the end of age. Lord God, thank You for this wonderful time. We claim the victory and we give You back all the glory and all the praise in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. God bless everyone. Have a blessed day. Have a blessed week ahead. Hallelujah.